Now, our first guest is a designer, a presenter, and an actress, but is best known as one-fifth of the globally idolised girl group Girls Aloud.
Before we hear how five wannabe pop stars took over the pop world, let's remind ourselves of just a few of their absolute bangers.
Go, girls, go, 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 go. We girls gonna take control. You boys better know, no, no. We girls gonna run this show. Go, girls, go, 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 go.
Come on, it is Kimberley Walsh. Yes! We have
Hello
people.
Guys. I got the pink memo too.
Yes. I'm glad you did.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Breaking us up. We just saw people outside in the newsroom dancing to that. Everyone inside here is dancing to that. I'm sorry, but it's just banger after banger after blooming banger when it comes to Girls Aloud. Yes, I adore you. You're one of my favourite groups. You always came with great dance moves, Kimberley. Do you still remember them all?
Yeah, I think I definitely do not remember them all, but yeah, they are really good songs to get you going in the gym or on a night out. You definitely want to get up and dance, don't you? I do remember some of the moves, obviously, but you know, I wouldn't like to try and do a whole routine now.
But I know we're in lockdown and you're emerging from it in England, but you know, nightclubs aren't there. But when you were in nightclubs and a song came on or you're around friends, would you ever be able, would you bust out moves ever?
I am that cringy person, I cannot lie. So I've done a few musicals recently. I did Big the Musical like a year or so ago, and there was quite a few young ones in the cast. So if we went out on like cast drinks and any Girls Aloud songs came on, I felt obliged, you know, to just show them
well,
a few moves. I am just that cringy mum.
just to be sociable, she'd bust out a few.
But I'm just saying, if I was one of those cast members and Kimberley Walsh started dancing to Girls Aloud in front of me, I'd be a puddle on the floor just going, is this really happening?
We have literally done like The Promise with me and four other members, girls and boys from the cast, and they thoroughly enjoyed themselves.
Brilliant.
Great song as well. No, I mean, it's hard to imagine Girls Aloud without you, but if we throw our minds back to pop stars, The Rivals, you were actually told, listen, time to go home, Kimberley, you haven't made the band.
Yeah.
That was devastating, surely.
Yeah, do you know what? I was just telling somebody this the other day that had no idea that this had happened to me. But yeah, I wasn't in the original final 10, so I wasn't meant to do the live shows. So I went back to like my my waitressing jobs. I went back to uni, signed up for my third year. And then literally, like, the day after I signed up for my third year at uni, Louis Walsh knocks on the door and says, actually, there's
You're
a place
back in.
For you. And goes in to bring you back. And I was like, is this a wind-up, Louis? But, yeah, I left Bradford, where I'm from, up north, on, like, the next morning. And I've never really gone back. Like, it's just crazy.
I know. It's been a great journey for you. It certainly has. But Louis, you mentioned Louis and, of course, your whiplash moment when he walked in to say, we want you back in again. It's been well documented and you, of course, have spoken about it yourself. Was that almost as far as Louis's management went with Girls Aloud?
Yeah, I mean, I think Louis would be quite honest about this himself. I think I don't know if he knew really how to handle girls. I think he's great with boy bands. He's got that locked down. But girls, I think he was a bit like, what do I do? So, yeah, me and Louis have had our moments over the years. But I kind of, we've made up. We've kissed and made up. And now he's just kind of a bit like that annoying uncle that you see. And you're like, oh, here he is. No doubt he's gonna have something to say. But no, we've buried all that now. It's all good.
And we do love to hear that. We love a happy ending. But there has been criticism recently from the likes of Jedward, Cher Lloyd and Rebecca Ferguson of TV talent shows. Kimberley, I'm sure you heard about it. But with Girls Aloud, because, you know, I suppose Louis wasn't that involved, did it feel like you were a little bit different? Did you have more control over your careers?
We definitely did not feel like a puppet pop group. I don't think that they'd ever, even the record company had ever experienced like five girls that wanted to be so involved, because usually you've got that manager in between you and the label, so you can't really get involved. But we didn't know any different. So we'd be like, hi, yeah, we're coming in. We don't like that song. We want to chat about it. Oh, no, we don't like the new artwork. We're coming in. And they were just like, what? But for us, it was actually brilliant because we learned a lot. We felt like we were in control of our own destiny, and it felt a little bit more organic and authentic, I guess, for us.
And because you didn't know any different, like, you know, over the years, you've had the likes of The Guardian. Chris Martin from Coldplay was dying to write you a song. He never got the right one for you. But you've had so many people banging the Girls Aloud drum that when you look at other people that didn't have control, do you kind of... You must be relieved that you didn't fall into that trap.
Yeah, I think, you know, we have a lot to thank our incredible producers, Xenomanias, for. I think what they did was they kind of fed off us and what was going on in our lives and our personalities. And they would always want us in the studio for the entire process, which for us was a little bit annoying. Sometimes we're like, oh, my God, we're in the studio for months and months. But I see why now, because they wanted it to feel like we were part of it. And even little things that we said would give them another lyric. So it did feel like a really collaborative process. So I guess we were very, very lucky in that respect.
And massively successful into the bargain, to the point that the demand is still there. And hard to believe, you've mentioned Mom Dancing. 20 years next year will mark the 20th anniversary of Girls Aloud. So naturally, with fans still... you know, pining for another jaunt and another chance to see you live. Is the pressure on for you to get back together again in some way to mark 20 years?
Yeah, I mean, I think it's so lovely that people actually care and want us to do something. Of course, at the moment, our focus is just on Sarah and just, you know, supporting her through everything. But yeah, I think it is a real testament that people are asking, are we going to do anything? Like, it's 20 years. So it's lovely that people do still care.
And I suppose it is, just for people who might know, Sarah Harding, one of the members of Girls Aloud, is, of course, she's fighting cancer. Like, she's got cancer at the moment, and she's letting us into her lives a little bit. And I'm sure that's affecting you all. And what you can do is rally around and just take each day as it comes rather than think of the 20th anniversary.
Exactly. And we just want her to feel all the love that we're feeling from everybody going to her. So our job at the moment is just to pass that back to her, really, and just be there for whatever she needs.
And Sarah, and all of you were involved in the style of Girls Aloud, shall we talk about a little bit, Kimberley, because when it comes to girl bands and boy bands, it's like it's the same outfit with a slight variation. I remember the round.
Like us tonight.
Yeah, we did this for you. We did this for you when we were in a band. And
really,
like, I remember. Like, look at us, with all three of us. But, like, you know, I remember the real gypsy skirt stage and all this kind of stuff. Was there times when the five of you would walk in going, no, I'm not doing this. I'm not doing this anymore.
Well, unfortunately, I don't think we had the knowledge that we probably needed. So we were just like, yeah, this seems like a great idea. But there's definitely some moments that I look back at. I think mainly around the sort of No Good Advice, you know, rocky, rebellious, silver leather outfit stage that I'm like, yeah, probably shouldn't have gone there. But I'm kind of proud. I'm proud of our, like, biology phase with our little pencil skirt look, because I remember seeing, like, all the ladies on their way out with the girls dressed in their little pencil skirts and red belts. And I felt like really excited that they'd kind of copied our style.
Yeah, I remember dancing to the pencil skirt with the big thick belt. That was me for a year, just being like Girls Aloud. Absolutely. That was you.
You see the influence you had.
Huge influence. Loved it.
Yeah, but now, of course, these days, you're designing yourself and you're wearing whatever you want because you're designing your own stuff with Regatta. And with the mask wearing that's still going on, is that allowing you the opportunity, Kimberley, to go out for a little walk yourself and then look about and see people wearing clothes that you've created?
Yeah, I always notice somebody in Regatta now. And to be honest, a lot of people are wearing it because, as you said, our lifestyle has changed somewhat over the last year. And I think everybody appreciates the outdoors so much more. But you do need to be ready for those eventualities because you never know when the heavens are going to open. I know the Irish weather is very similar to what we have and it's just so unpredictable. So for me, working with Regatta and having two boys that never want to be inside was like the perfect combination.
And with two boys, you've got a third on the way. You're fulfilling your brief of being a love machine, Kimberley, aren't you?
That's the first time I've had it put quite like that. That's actually hilarious. But yeah, oh, do you know what? My boys are amazing. And they've actually, I feel like they've got me through this lockdown. Like as much as people say, oh, how do you get through it with kids? I feel like as hard as it is, they're also like such a brilliant focus to stay positive and just like get on with it, really. You don't want them to know that anything's weird or anything's different, you know?
And it seems, is it yourself and your sister? Are you trying to make a super big pop band or football team? Is it only, it's only boys?
They're on the way to a football team.
Yeah, by the end of July, we will have seven boys. They are thrilled. And we are just picturing ourselves at the spa in a few years' time when they're all like playing football, doing golf, whatever they're doing.
Seven.
But no, have the best time.
Wow. Well done. Fair play to you all. Our love machine, and she's fantastic. Kimberley Walsh's new collection with Regatta. It is, of course, available now to have a piece of Kimberley yourself. Thank you so much for chatting with us. Cheers.
Oh, great to talk to you, Kimberley. Give our love to Sarah.
I will. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Kimberley. Still to come, and we have to say a big up to our producer, Daniel, who was the love machine. He's all about that question there. Still to come, we're talking to sports photographer Stephen McCarthy about how lockdown restrictions helped him win big in a global photography competition.
We'll see you back here after the break.